I was always curious about something is how do you have a snowball fight in the desert when it never snows? You bring your own snowballs!
I think we might be a little lost.
Uh-oh.
And it's starting to get dark.
Interesting. What's up ahead, babe? Some more.
Where? Oh, look, Dave, petroglyphs.
I see it.
They look like you and me. Yeah. Oh, you and me.
What's up? How you doing?
I'm sitting on the edge of a cliff. Don't get too close.
That's right.
So we're doing our morning thing. Tanya is off getting the coffee. And then we're going to head off to Valley of Fire, which is just over an hour outside of Las Vegas. It's our first time camping there, as we said, and it's supposed to be absolutely beautiful. They do have campgrounds that have fire pits. It's supposed to get actually into the 20s tonight, so we're hoping to have a nice campfire and also cook up some nice dinner as well. I'm looking forward to it. Here comes the coffee. Doo-doo-doo. Here comes the coffee. It's all right. Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo.
So, what about that campfire tonight? You excited?
I'm totally psyched about it.
First time!
But we actually haven't had a campfire, camping in the Echo yet.
I know.
And of course...
We've done a propane fire pit at the KOA.
Well, that's true.
But it's not like a campfire.
Yeah,
so,
we have real wood, so hopefully, fingers crossed,
right.
We have a campground.
High five, you brought the real wood!
The one thing about this area, you can only have fires in designated fire pits
right.
And campgrounds here right now. In this area, so.
And each one of those spots has one.
Yeah,
if you can get a spot, right?
Exactly, so fingers crossed.
So I was like reading some things here about Valley of Fire. What's really cool, it has like so many trails. And according to this article, you can cover them all in a day, or you can cover many of them in a day.
Oh, wow.
You know, so there's all different kind of look-off points. One in particular was, remember we talked about before, it was Elephant Head Rock, or is it Elephant
right.
Rock?
Looks like an elephant trunk
yes,
or something, right?
Exactly. So I'm looking forward to that. Now, we do have the America's Beautiful Pass, but from what I'm reading, it's a state park, so the America's Beautiful Annual Pass doesn't really apply there. So if that is true, then it's $10.
$10 entrance fee?
$10 entrance fee.
And that's just
fee.
To get into the park, and then
correct.
There might be a kind of additional campground fee
right.
Part of it, yeah.
Exactly. About 8 miles
from the first campground. There's two campgrounds. We're gonna check out the smaller one first and see if we get lucky. We've already seen boondocking.
I know.
Boondockers out there, so we may be coming back and do some boondocking.
Well,
we'll see.
I'm just hoping they're like, okay, well, you have to pay a fee for the park.
Right.
I just want to camp and enjoy it. So I'm hoping they're just more of like the hippie style.
Exactly.
Just chilling.
Exactly. Like find free camping.
Free camping. Versus us, where I want to find a bathroom, potentially.
Yes. We're a little bit into the facilities
for
at this
now,
point.
For still, now, for now.
We're still working on it.
We're still working
on it. Alright, so I went to the visitor center.
Yeah.
I made a few wrong turns.
What do you mean wrong turns?
Well, I went right out of here, back towards the entrance. Of course, the visitor center is further in.
Yeah.
But so I turned around and went down that way. But they have an annual pass for the Nevada State Parks, which is $250. For the year. So I decided to get that.
No way. Did you really?
I mean, you figure two nights here camping with the entrance fee, it's $40 just for two nights. And we're going to do so much more than that. So, right. And it comes with a passport book. You have to stamp.
Cool.
Yeah. So we're going to start stamping the Nevada State Parks.
Give me.
Yeah. You'll do those stamping.
There it is. And so that right there, it says the park passport stamp. So park staff may be in the field, and if they're not available, then you can actually issue your own stamp. So I think
we'll see. Here. Yeah, there's a stamp in here.
Yeah.
I'll hold that up for you. Let's see if there's actually any ink.
Yeah.
Will that work?
All right, thank you. And yeah, all right.
We're going for it. Here we go.
I'm going for it. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. It's official.
Hey,
yay!
It worked.
Valley of Fire.
Yeah. Just put one foot in front of the other. I smell like a wood fire going, right?
Just put one foot in front of. Oh, there's a, I see him sticking out his peak of this little ground squirrel.
Yeah, I see that too, way up there.
Little chipmunk, he's standing up. He's like looking.
I see it, he's looking at us.
Hello,
I'm sure if you can
buddy.
See it. Right up that way a little
bit.
Yeah,
he's looking at us. He said that there's quite a bit of bighorn sheep.
Yeah, that would be exactly.
So bighorn sheep is just sometimes they'll walk through the camps, and I think they come out later in the evening when things are a little quiet. But
that cave looks cool. You're supposed to be telling us.
Wow!
Oh my goodness, that is so cool up there. That looks so cool.
That's amazing.
It almost looks like Petroglyphs, but it's not.
Exactly.
Just the designs of the rock.
Wow. That looks like an animal head. That's pretty cool. What would you say? It's a mouse?
Looks like a mouse. Whatever you're saying, I'm sure it's correct.
A mouse or a dog? Maybe it's a dog.
Dog
kind of. There's the ears tucked back, ready to greet its owner.
Yeah.
And then there's the nose. Well, it's funny, you see tiny little paws too, so you might almost get, you might also get gray foxes out here.
Oh yeah, right?
It's kind of fun.
This is beautiful.
Isn't it so pretty? And the air is just so refreshing.
I'm just dumbfounded by like all these, the rock formations. Like everywhere you turn, there's a different rock to look at that has these different crevices in there. I'm going up to the Sunny Peak.
Okay. Heading to the sun. I'm excited that we're gonna have grilling up some good stuff.
Oh, nice
campfire tonight.
A campfire and some grilling.
It's gonna be awesome.
Grilling and chilling.
Grilling and chilling. You got it. I like that. Uh-oh.
And it's starting to get dark. If I'm looking correctly at the footprints, they're going the other direction.
Exactly. What are we doing this way?
What are we doing?
We're kind of heading out into the sand. It's like all this kind of red clay on the ground.
Look at that.
So beautiful. I know. Want to head back, babe?
Yeah, I think we're on the right path heading back, and I'm starving.
I know, I want to get that grill going, maybe.
Yeah, I have a feeling grill and fire pit sounds really nice right about now.
I like that.
Let's go!
The sun's starting to get down closer towards the horizon there over the rock peak.
You gotta focus.
Stay focused, baby.
Stay focused. You haven't seen nothing yet. Wait till you get that little down.
You gonna do that backflip?
Oh yeah, of course. Hold on.
Nice.
Ready, Harry? Yeah.
You got it. I'm waiting
for
the editing.
That landing?
No, I didn't.
Watch one more time.
Here it comes.
Yeah.
Oh. You nailed it.
Whoa, how was that?
You nailed the dismount.
Thank you. Was that a 10?
Of course it is.
10.
This one goes to 11.
We're like this close to getting back to the RV to eat because I am starving. You ready?
I'm definitely hungry.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Tell y'all how excited I am to be out here in the Valley of Fire with Dave and us just really trying to you know, start to warm up to some of the cooler nights and camping. Obviously, you know, we're having a heat issue. So we do have a little space heater to keep the coach indoors warm. We're going to just keep the heat on low, and hopefully circulate some heat inside some of those compartments so it doesn't conk out, but it should be fine. During the days are pretty warm anyway. But I'm also excited because tonight's dinner is going to be something a lot of you guys really enjoyed seeing. I think this was in episode 6, or was it Sam's Town? And we actually made some ribeye. So we're going with some ribeye tonight, which is going to be nice. We're going to have some white onion slice with some olive oil, salt, pepper. Dave's going to be putting out on the grill some post oak to really kind of soak in some post oak flavors in these steaks because it was dynamite. And right now, we're just going to relax and have one of our favorite kind of cocktails. a little burpee.
And I love these glasses. Like, yeah, they're plastic, but they almost have that real sort of cocktail glass spin on it. So, hey.
Hey, baby.
How you doing?
I'm doing great.
Nice.
Got some leftover coals from the last time because I closed it off, so.
Oh, sweet.
This thing is like stacked and loaded here.
Well, I got some stacked and loaded for you.
Ooh, that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Hold on a Thanks, second. Babe. I'm going to go grab mine.
A little bourbon, huh?
Oh, yeah. Well, you got to warm the insides.
Like first campfire.
First campfire.
Love it, babe. Thanks so much.
Oh, you're welcome. I love
you.
I want to show you.
I like these fancy glasses.
Give me in the light. It sparkles. Stay right? They look fancy.
Stay in the light.
Stay in the light. To a great night.
Right. Great night, babe. I love you so much.
I love you so much. Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, time for me to get in there and prep that steak.
Go.
All right, cue the B-roll for the sizzle. Here we go. All right, here we go. First
right,
bite.
First bite. I hope you like it.
Cheers.
Cheers, love.
Boom.
Mmm. Mmm. Wow.
I don't care what you tell me. Grilling steak and then infusing it with some of that post oak in there.
It's crazy, right?
Ooh.
It's crazy good.
And, oh, careful.
I know. A little wobbly table.
Cheers to a great night. And I'm looking forward to that fire.
I know. I'm looking forward to that, too. It's going to be awesome.
It's going to be wonderful.
We'd start it now, but I think it might smoke us out.
Oh, it definitely would smoke us out.
About that.
At least when we don't have the food in front of us, we can shift the chairs around.
Exactly.
All right, babe. It's time to light up some of those Vaseline and cotton balls.
Yes. Yes, that's right. This is actually a little trick we learned from Chad from Living the Van Life.
Yeah.
And I actually think he learned it from someone else. So yeah. It's like we're passing it down.
We're passing it
so
down.
So it's a little Vaseline in a cotton ball.
Vaseline
put it on under.
Cotton ball.
Right down under here.
So throw it right down into the fire.
And let's start it up.
Oh yeah, there it is. I've got a cotton ball.
Put it in a little closer there.
Nice.
All right, ready, baby?
But you also have lighter logs, so you're probably pretty good.
This is yeah, just... and it's all natural, but here we go. Let's start it up.
Thank you.
Good morning, good morning. On this brisk, cold morning here at Valley of Fire, I will honestly say we slept well. You know, the temperatures dropped 27 degrees. And of course, when you don't have heat, you're kind of nervous about that. You guys know we haven't had heat for a while, so we're trying to get this fixed. But we figured out keeping a little space heater in there, and we're able to get enough heat from the heater to pump into some of those different compartments to keep it warm. I felt like we made it a big accomplishment in being able to camp in cold weather. So that's a positive sign, and hopefully we're gonna have this thing fixed sooner than later. But I got some coffee in hand, Dave's inside just tidying up a bit. And we're gonna go try and explore some of these really cool trails. So I'm gonna enjoy this cup of coffee. I think Dave's probably gonna come out in just a minute. And we're gonna explore, but wow, it is so nice to be out here. You wake up and you're surrounded by this beautiful red rock. It's just a Valley of Fire. Oh boy. So we're on our way to check out, where Dave, we're going up to check out some petroglyphs over here, right?
Petroglyphs are right around here. I mean, they're all over the place, apparently, so we're going to go check some out. Supposed to be a little, nice little walk. Not sure how high we'll go up there, but we did see a friend of ours we met kind of climb up to the top.
Janine, amazing.
Yeah. So, it's so beautiful. I mean, it's so peaceful, too.
Try and talk to the bird. Look how beautiful that bird is. Can I walk up? Oh. He just goes back and forth, back and forth. Gorgeous. What kind of bird is that? Hi, honey. I see you.
Petroglyphs everywhere, I think.
That's amazing. Look how high up they go.
Right? I know. I think there's something. What's up ahead, babe? Some more.
Where? Oh!
Yeah, right over that way, right?
Oh,
yeah.
Man. Petroglyphs!
Wow, look at that. So cool.
Wow.
Unbelievable.
Oh, this is amazing. Wow. Definitely gotta try and get a couple of photos of that. Wow. That's amazing.
That is so cool.
How old do you think these are? Like 2,000 year old petroglyphs? About 2,000 year old?
Yeah, I don't know personally, but.
I thought I was reading something
about
scattered around, you'll find like petroglyphs ranging somewhere in 2,000 year old petroglyphs.
Sure, you're right.
But that's incredible.
That is so cool. Look at that.
That's amazing. So what does that mean? Hen circle.
Right?
Hen circle.
That's incredible.
Can you believe this? Like seriously, you don't even touch it. It's like.
No, definitely
just
not.
Leave it alone and.
King Kong climbing.
Or when he's kind of sitting like this, arms down, head, top, there's like the face, and then that little lower lip is the shoulders when they kind of sit like that.
Oh yeah, there you go.
Right?
I see it, yeah.
It's like a gorilla.
You're crazy.
King Kong.
King Kong comes.
King Kong.
To Vegas.
To yeah, Vegas.
It's about an hour outside of Vegas. This is amazing.
I know, just 1 hour. Thank you.
pretty cool.
Oh, I thought it was amazing. I really appreciated seeing that up close like that. And now, of course, learning now it's like 4,000 years.
Oh, 4,000 years. Unbelievable.
But for anyone watching this coming here, don't vandalize.
Oh, yeah, I know.
I mean, they've been 4,000 years, and then you see some of that vandalism, which is not cool.
Look at that, a little nose there. Could be a little nose there, maybe. Yeah.
So I'm trying to record little bits and pieces here, maybe pop them up on our Instagram and see if folks can kind of guess what the formations of the rocks are.
Exactly.
You're right, I think that looked a little human-like for sure.
Might get more creative after a few beers.
That's a good point, after a few beers.
Or something else.
Before we get hiking, I want to take Tanya and show her the visitor center here. It's actually a really cool visitor center. And I just actually went in quickly before when I got the annual pass for the Nevada National Parks. But I want to check it out, maybe learn something about the geology and other things in the park.
Ah, so good way to start. So kind of basically let you know if you have like a couple hours to see things or if you have like a half day or a full day. And it tells you.
Gives you recommended,
they
kind
recommended
of itinerary.
Exactly,
it's
like
kind
a
cool.
Recommended itinerary.
So if you have 2 hours.
You got this here.
Right.
So I also recommend taking a picture of these. So
that's a good idea.
You'll always have them. So if you come back, because there's so much to explore here, you'll always have them.
I love that. You can do this. If you have half a day,
yeah,
you can do that.
And if you have a full day, you can do that
over. Yeah, if you have a full day, there it is.
There's no free maps available, but you could probably buy some
right.
That's not free maps.
Your maps require.
Say you get a $8 version of the map here.
Oh
nature
yeah.
Guide.
Oh yeah, that must be the.
Because it signs it no free maps. But
right.
You can get a purchase one for $8 here.
Exactly. Yay! Is that the Elephant Rock?
Oh yeah. As we lurk through the visitor center, up ahead. Hiding in the corner, in the crevice. It looks like a wolverine or a badger of some sort. Oh my goodness gracious. Mascalte.
Oh, Danny, check it.
Oh, yeah.
Desert varnish. Remember all that?
Yeah.
Sort of the black particles you saw in there? Well, apparently, this dark stone is called desert varnish. And it looks super cool. It's like, iron, it's when iron and manganese presents in the rock, interacts with water and living organisms. So it's like microbes living in those things, which causes
right.
This.
And it's amazing how you see so much of this black on the rocks, and then they kind of used it to carve those petroglyphs
yes.
In the rocks.
Oh
right?
Yeah, and I think the one that's actually in this photo, we
right?
Walked past I while think we were staying at the camp.
That looks awfully familiar.
Right? Ooh.
Yeah, no, it's really cool to think about this as being underwater, right? So 500 million years ago, this was a shallow sea.
Well, we kind of thought that.
Oh, yeah, right? No, definitely. This whole area. And I'm hoping maybe we'll see some like fossilized shells, like brachiopods or something, if we keep our eyes open. There's like trails all around, I think.
There are.
Right?
Yeah.
Unbelievable. But it is amazing to be, you know, staring. You kind of walk down and you look over and there's like a 4,000-year-old petroglyph just all over the rock face.
I know. And it's super cool. I mean, I'm starting to notice a pattern that a lot of this petroglyph seems to be drawn into the desert varnish.
Right.
Maybe there's some sort of, what do you call that? Almost like a... preserves it, like a preservative
oh, yeah.
In it that preserves it so long
absolutely.
That
I know,
it doesn't
right?
Weather away even with the wind and the
exactly.
Potential rains or whatever weather conditions are out here, it's manning the storm. end of the trail is about 100 feet, 30 meters this way.
This way, babe.
Be careful. Yeah. So this is Mouse's.
This is the mouse tank.
This is the mouse tank, and Mouse wasn't any old mouse.
No, Mouse was an outlaw, and this is kind of the supposed story is where he hid out and potentially was able to survive here because the mouse tank was always filled with water. Except today, I don't really see any down there.
Yeah, no water down there today.
No water down there
But apparently
today.
When Mouse was on the run, came here and was able to drink some water.
Yeah, well, I'm going to enjoy hanging out here for a few minutes.
It's a beautiful spot.
So there's this really, as you can see here, this is called Rainbow Vista. It's sort of an overlook point as we're heading from the mouse tank to our next destination. But look how vivid the colors are of the stone behind us. It's so, it's speechless. This is Silica Dome.
Okay, so Silica Dome.
And it says this, the sandstone formations are so prominent into the Valley of Fire, made of sand grains that are almost pure silica.
Wow, ooh. Okay.
What's up?
What's up? How you doing?
I'm sitting on the edge of a cliff. Don't get too close.
That's right.
Then it won't look like one. Oh, I'm on the edge of a cliff. Hello?
Hear that echo?
I heard it, yeah. We're serenading the folks.
Oh. Wow, so these stones here, this is the Seven Sisters. Oh, there's a transect. Oh, that's really amazing.
So what do you think, babe?
Was that a good impression?
I think so. I think you got it.
We did it! High five!
High five, all right. This was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Oh, it's amazing. It does look like an elephant's.
It does. I feel like we've just scratched the surface. We have a lot to explore here at the Valley of Fire still.
Yeah, we do. But this is a really cool spot.
Absolutely.
Catching this right around sunset, too.
Exactly.
Right? So that was a lot of fun.
Oh, it's been a great 2 days here. Valley of Fire is awesome.
Yeah, there's so much to see and do, and I feel like we've only just scratched the surface.
Yeah, I completely agree.
Yeah, and where we are right now, this Elephant Rock, there are so many kids enjoying it. Yeah.
Oh, exactly. You might actually hear them, although I think they've moved on.
I think they've moved on.
Yeah, but, a lot. So expect a lot of kids, a lot of folks pulling onto the side of the road to check out Elephant Rock.
And boy, can they climb. They're climbing up these rocks like it's no problem
whatsoever. No fear at all.
But the sun is setting, and I do not see any street lights here, so I think we need to roll.
It's going to be a fun drive.
Yeah.
Maybe the stars will come out tonight. The sky's clearing.